हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ इम्तियाज़ बेगम, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट, गवर्नमेंट फर्स्ट ग्रेड कॉलेज, चिकबलापुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक सेशन 8 ऑफ एम्प्लॉई वेलफेयर एंड सोशल सिक्योरिटी. अंडर दैट, मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स ऑफ वेलफेयर मेजर. सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट different types of social security and welfare measures. Which are the different types of social securities? It may be in the form of provision of canteen facility, medical facility, recreational facility, educational facility, providing sanitary facility, providing industrial safety provisions, provisions for restrooms, firefighting arrangements, fresh air, providing recreational facility, traveling allowance, industrial training, paid leave, sickness and maternity benefit, provident fund benefits, social insurance schemes, so on. So in today's class, we will discuss about its merits and demerits. Before that, learning objective of the chapter. The objective of this unit is to enable the students understand the merits and demerits of welfare measures. Session outcome: the student will be able to explain the merits and demerits of welfare measures. So now we will discuss what are the different merits of welfare. Labor welfare measures provides various benefits for the development of the worker. The important benefits or merits are, first one, high employee retention. So this welfare facility enables an organization to create a positive environment for its employees, which in turn creates high job satisfaction among the employees. In the absence of any serious dissatisfaction, the employee may not feel the need for quitting the organization. In turn, he remains in the organization for the long time. Thus, employee welfare facilitates reduce labor turnover and improves employee retention in the organization. If our organization is providing better facilities, they will not think of going to some other organization. Instead, they will stay back or work in our organization for a long period. Next one, it improves the productivity and efficiency. So here, happy employees are more productive employee. It means welfare facility enables an organization to improve the involvement and commitment of its employee by fulfilling their needs and keeping them satisfied. So understandably, high involvement and commitments will be there from the side of employee, which will result in high productivity and the efficiency. The next one we have is better focus on job. Employees are often distracted by their personal problems, maybe housing, maybe education, maybe creatures for their young one, so on. So if these problems are taken care by the employer, the employee would be able to focus completely on their profession and achieve better performance. The next one, preserve physical and mental health. Healthcare and insurance facilities enables the employees to attend to their health problems properly without bothering about cost. Periodic medical checkups undertaken by the organization facilitates early diagnosis of the employee's health problem and attending to them properly and promptly. The presence of gyms, games, recreation, sports facility helps the employees actively in several ways, like stress reduction and also in keeping the body and mind sound. The next one, improve the standard of living by providing facilities like housing, education, loans. Organization helps the employee to improve their standard of living and comforts of life over a period of time. Next one, labor management relation. An important concept is the relationship between the employer and the employee. Employee welfare facility certainly helps the organization in developing mutual trust and harmony in the labor management relation and ensures effective goal accomplishment. Next one, it improves morale and loyalty of the workers. Employee welfare programs makes the employee very loyal and boosts his morale by making them happy and satisfied. Next one, it reduces government intervention. Voluntary efforts for the welfare of workers reduces the threat of further government interventions. Next, we have demerits of welfare measure. Though employee welfare facility have several merits, they also have few demerits. They are high labor cost. Since employee welfare facilities are made available to all the employees without any discrimination, they impose a major financial burden on the organization. Invariably, they push up the labor cost and the total cost of production. Next one we have is absence of measurement tool. As employee welfare facilities are not linked to the performance or productivity of the employees directly, it is difficult to measure their efficiency in achieving the intended goals. The management may hesitate to spend too much money on these facilities without knowing their actual effect on the performance. Next we have is lack of justification for expenditure. Sometimes neither the organization nor the employees are able to justify the spending of huge amount on welfare facility, since they may benefit only for few employees. Next we have is risk of executing statutory welfare facility. Statutory welfare facilities are nothing but provided by the law. So sometimes an organization may be financially too weak to execute the welfare facility as required by the provision of law. Despite this, if it is compelled to provide such facility just to fulfill the statutory requirements, its financial position may be further weakened, and the threat for the survival of the organization will also be there. So these are some of the merits and demerits of welfare measures. Few questions are, which of the following is not the merit of welfare measure? High labor cost, it is a demerit, not the merit. Next one, employee welfare facilities reduces labor turnover and improves employee retention in the organization. Employee involvement and commitments leads to increased productivity in the organization. One of the demerit of employee welfare is high labor cost. So some of the welfare activities includes providing holiday home, canteen facility, recreational facility. So thank you very much for giving me an opportunity. Thank you.